world is changing. Bigger missiles, different missiles.
Precision gunfire support. We move into the future. Railgun, solid-state laser.
Lasers, railgun.
Megawatts of power at your fingertips.
The USS Zumwalt, DDG 1000, a very large and stealthy Navy destroyer that has been beset by hurdles for much of its life, was put back in the water Friday after undergoing 14 months of work that saw its original and cost-prohibitive 155mm advanced gun systems replaced with launchers that will eventually fire intermediate-range conventional prompt-strike hypersonic missiles. Originally built for literal combat, the Zumwalt-class warship features an artillery system capable of firing 155mm guided shells at a distance of 60 nautical miles, 69 miles or 111 kilometers. The shells' projected cost of $800,000 each risked inflating the warship's overall cost, forcing the eventual fleet reduction from 32 to 3 warships. The 14 500-ton vessel can be outfitted with a host of missiles, including the standard missile 2 Block 3AZ and evolved Sea Sparrow surface-to-air missiles, as well as Tomahawk land-attack cruise missiles. Zumwalt destroyer floated with hypersonic launcher upgrade. The U.S. Navy is transforming a costly flub into a potent weapon with the first shipborne hypersonic weapon, which is being retrofitted aboard the first of its 3 stealthy destroyers. The U.S. has had several types of hypersonic weapons in development for the past 2 decades, but recent tests by both Russia and China have added pressure to the U.S. military to hasten their production. Hypersonic weapons travel beyond Mach 5, 5 times the speed of sound, with added maneuverability making them harder to shoot down. One of the U.S. programs in development and planned for the Zumwalt is the conventional prompt strike. It would launch like a ballistic missile and then release a hypersonic glide vehicle that would travel at speeds 7 to 8 times faster than the speed of sound before hitting the target. The weapon system is being developed jointly by the Navy and Army. Each of the Zumwalt-class destroyers would be equipped with 4 missile tubes, each with 3 of the missiles for a total of 12 hypersonic weapons per ship. Hypersonic upgrade. As part of the upgrade, the original twin 155mm advanced gun systems on the destroyer have been replaced with missile tubes for the conventional prompt strike weapon. Each 87-inch, 221-centimeter tube can hold a trio of common hypersonic glide goatee weapons with a reported range in excess of 2,775 kilometers. The conventional prompt strike has an identical design to the U.S. Army's ground-based Dark Eagle long-range hypersonic weapon system and the same rocket-boosted missile, only differing in the launch platform. The unpowered missile, the common hypersonic glide body, puts the payload to the desired altitude and speed. After that, the glide vehicle detaches from the booster and dives toward the target through the atmosphere at a hypersonic speed above Mach 5. Provide a combination of speed, range, maneuverability, and altitude that enables highly survivable and rapid defeat of time-critical and heavily defended targets. A combination of vehicle speed, considered far exceeding the hypersonic threshold, and unpredictable trajectory make interception extremely difficult, even for a dense, layered missile defense system. The upgrade is expected to be complete by 2025, paving the way for testing. The entire fleet of 3 Zumwalt warships is expected to have the capability by 2028. Critics say there is too little bang for the buck. This particular missile costs more than a dozen tanks, All it gets you is a precise non-nuclear explosion, someplace far, far away. Is it really worth the money? The answer is, most of the time, the missile costs much more than any target you can destroy with it, said Lauren Thompson. But they provide the capability for Navy vessels to strike an enemy from a distance of thousands of kilometers, outside the range of most enemy weapons, and there is no effective defense against them. Conventional missiles that cost less aren't much of a bargain if they are unable to reach their targets. The U.S. is accelerating development because hypersonics have been identified as vital to U.S. national security, with survivable and lethal capabilities. Fielding new capabilities that are based on hypersonic technologies is a priority for the Defense Department to sustain and strengthen our integrated deterrence and to build enduring advantages, he said. The Zumwalt was envisioned as providing land attack capability with an advanced gun system with rocket-assisted projectiles to open the way for Marines to charge ashore. But the system, featuring 155mm guns hidden in stealthy turrets, was cancelled because each of the rocket-assisted projectiles cost between $800,000 and $1 million. Despite the stain on its reputation, the three Zumwalt-class destroyers remain the Navy's most advanced surface warship in terms of new technologies.